In this video, I'm going to show you how to learn more about the molecule you've now built. So first of all, if you look over on the model view window on the right, you'll notice there's now a little arrow that expands to go down. The thing we have here is info about the molecule. If you double click on that, it brings up a little window with some more information. A couple of things to point out here. The charge right now is zero. If I wanted to create an ion, I could increase that to make it a cation or decrease it to make it an anion. But right now I just have a neutral atom. It tells me the number of atoms in my molecule, the number of electrons, the chemical formula, the molecular mass. The energy right now is just going to show as zero because I haven't done a full quantum chemistry calculation on it. The dipole moment is basically a separation in charge. So if the electrons in the bond are not equally shared, there's going to be a dipole moment for the molecule, and the point group tells you about the symmetry of the molecule. I can also view the dipole for this molecule by clicking the little checkbox here, and you'll see that it's actually hidden by the atoms. One thing I can do is if I double-click the dipole, it brings up some options, so I can adjust the scale so that I can see that arrow. And you can see that it's pointing with the negative end towards the oxygen and the positive end towards the carbon, which is what we would expect. There's this atoms menu, which basically just shows you the list of atoms. And this can be helpful for selecting specific atoms. So sometimes it's kind of a pain to use the magic wand to select the atoms. Then using these for the selection is useful if you need to select multiple atoms. Hold down the control button and then click on those atoms in whatever order you want. We'll come back to that in a minute. We also have bonds. So in the bonds category, it does the same thing for selecting the different bonds in the molecule. And then last we have this surfaces category, and we will come back to that in the next video. So one thing that's often very helpful when you're looking at molecules is to know how long their bonds are and what those angles are between them. To find out that information with an IQmol, I need to select the relevant parameters. So for bond lengths, I can either select the bond directly, and you'll see it appears down in the bottom left corner. So the carbon-oxygen bond is 1.22 angstroms. The carbon-hydrogen bond, I need to have just that bond selected, is 1.08 angstroms. And I should find on the other side that carbon-hydrogen bond is also 1.08 angstroms. Instead of selecting the bonds, I could also select the atoms. So here I could select the oxygen and the carbon atom. If I select three atoms, I'm going to get an angle. And so if I want to know about the oxygen, carbon, hydrogen angle here, I would need to select oxygen, carbon, and hydrogen. And in this case, it does matter very much what order you select them in. So here I needed to select the oxygen first, the carbon, and the hydrogen. If I had done it in a different order, let's say I selected carbon first, and then oxygen and hydrogen, I'm going to get an angle of about 28 degrees, which is not what I would expect. Now I can also check the angle for hydrogen, carbon, hydrogen. And here again, it's very close to 120. So you may remember learning that when you have a double bond, it's going to push the other atoms further away. And so we would actually expect this carbon, hydrogen, carbon angle to be somewhat smaller than the oxygen-carbon-hydrogen angle. And the reason for that is the calculation that was done to minimize the structure used a very simple force field, which is known as UFF, or universal force field. And in future videos, we'll talk about ways that you can improve that estimation and get more accurate results.